What do you think of remaining celibate till marriage? Hey, hang on. Don't cut me off. Give me a minute to explain. Today, increasingly more millennials are choosing abstinence. It's a fast-growing trend, and you see more and more purity rings being worn. Celebrities like Mariah Carey also share these values, as many significant figures in history who either chose a life of celibacy, like Isaac Newton, or were abstinent until marriage, like Nikola Tesla. Proponents say that it makes a couple value each other more, develop relationship skills, and it raises the quality of communication, obliges partners to develop other ways to show affection. It assures a higher rate for a subsequent marriage, and most importantly, that they want to save themselves for that special person with whom they will live for life. And of course, many cite their religious beliefs as a major incentive not to have sex until after marriage. Now, I personally resonate with these reasons and the concept of abstinence. I've been celibate myself for 50 years, but actually those mentioned are secondary reasons and benefits of celibacy. Now, I'd like to explain the essential reason, hearing which you too may want to consider sexual restraint as one of your life choices. Life is about self-realization, and self-realization is about connecting with our spiritual essence, which means disconnecting from the idea that we are this body. But sex, along with the intense pleasure it generates, is an activity that reinforces a mistakenly bodily identification. Now, for that reason, yoga texts emphasize that sexual activity should be controlled and limited. And here's the punchline. Sex is meant solely for begetting children. It's not about enjoyment. It's not about contraceptives, and it's certainly not about abortion. It's about having children, and that's it, period. When a person lives a life of such abstinence, he or she can overcome the demands of the senses and overcome bodily identification and really come in tune with his spiritual essence. Now you may say, wow, if I give up sex pleasure, what do I get in return? For me, that's like asking, if I give up drugs, what do I get in return? Certain pleasures are not conducive to spiritual life, or like drugs, even to a healthy life. We need to seek a higher standard of pleasure, and my experience is that when you give yourself purely to kirtan, for instance, to chanting the Krishna mantra, the pleasure from that far outweighs that from a short sexual interlude. So, if self-realization and spirituality are your priorities in life, then consider abstinence before marriage and sex only for having children after marriage. Take it from me, you won't be missing anything. There's a good life to be had with little or no sex. Thank you.